Good morning, everyone. Thank you all for being here today. This is the start of a very, very exciting day at Babson, and we're thrilled to have all of you here today. My name is Clinton White. I'm the co-president of Babson's Energy and Environmental Club. It's a great privilege to be here today to welcome you to this groundbreaking ceremony for Babson's wind turbine installation.
The clean, renewable energy this residential-scale turbine will produce is only a minor benefit. Essentially, this is a demonstration project designed to deliver value by creating opportunities for Babson to develop its relationship with the entrepreneurial and rapidly expanding clean tech industry, to serve as a statement of our commitment to responsible environmental management, and to support ongoing sustainability initiatives at Babson.
I'd like to start by welcoming our Dean of Faculty to the stage, Dr. Fritz Fleischmann.
Good morning. On May 24th, 1844, Samuel Morse, after whom the Morse code is named, sent the first public telegraph message. The message read, "What hath God wrought?" Today, if we were to use similarly old-fashioned language, we might ask, what hath man wrought? What have we done? Through our ceaseless ingenuity, ambition, and hunger to change the planet we have inherited. Of course, some still deny that we have a problem, or if we do, that we have anything to do with it. Global warming, they say, is not our fault. It just came upon us. Fault or not, it is certainly our problem. And the environmental crisis is the most significant challenge of our age. Given that somebody or something hath wrought this, what ability do we have to deal with this crisis? What can we do? What should we do? We can do what Babson College is known for: create and collaborate, seize opportunities and marshal resources. In other words, engage in entrepreneurial behavior. But in addition, we can engage the entrepreneurial drive differently, not just in the spirit of economic individualism, but for a common good. Those two are not mutually exclusive to begin with. Enlightened self-interest is simply a deeper, longer-term understanding of personal self-interest. Global warming is a phenomenon that no one individual can run away from. And it is a threat that no one individual can fight single-handedly. It takes all of us to confront it and to deal with it. So, I welcome this turbine project as an example of Babson's entrepreneurial spirit, of our ability as a community to create and collaborate, to live in the real world, and to turn a crisis into an opportunity. I welcome it as a manifestation of the same human urge that has led our ancestors to cover this planet with cities and towns, with roads and airports, with factories and shopping malls, with hospitals and universities. This is the human urge to achieve and create. But the Babson wind turbine also represents our ability to get things done together and to articulate a common goal. This is the human urge to be part of a community that protects us against the unknown. Our wind turbine represents hope. We are not helpless. It represents optimism, an essential feature of the entrepreneurial spirit and of American business in general. Let the Babson wind turbine be such a reality, a symbol of what we can and need to do. Let us be awake then and work together so that we may be proud of what our generation hath wrought. A future filled not with distress and despair, but with opportunity and hope. Thank you.
On a daily basis, we're presented with new information that documents the enormous environmental challenges that have been created through our collective and unsustainable consumption of the planet's resources. In addressing these issues, we must continue to press for change and move together in the same spirit of collaboration that has contributed to the completed project before us. In this regard, let us move forward in unison to make sound decisions based on the careful consideration of the financial, environmental, and social implications of our actions in both our professional and personal lives.
Right, change.